Years now, they have been going strong, helping all us home cooks be better and more confident in the kitchen. Because it's a show all dedicated to this premise. A team of professional chefs come together and they test the recipes until they get it right. Until they work out all the myths and all of the problems and all of the struggles so that we home cooks can be very confident and successful in the kitchen. Every one of the recipes, and there are 400 in this book, from all 10 seasons of the show, were tested on average 30 to 50 times before the chefs were happy with them and they would go on the air on the show and then ultimately end up in the cookbook. So including the current 10th season, every one of the 10 seasons of recipes are in this book. And we've got it today on 5 Easy Payments. Julia Collin-Davidson is back with us. Great to see you,
so
Angel.
So nice to see you. Happy Thanksgiving.
You know what you are? You are my walking food encyclopedia. That's what
Thank you
are.
Thank you. That's I a real that compliment coming from you.
Well, you are awesome because you and your team really demystify so many cooking methods in the kitchen. So we feel confident. We feel brave. We feel encouraged.
Right. You can make new things and know that'll work out. You won't waste money. I mean, think about this. This cut of meat, this is a tenderloin. It's a holiday special. This can cost over $100 from a supermarket.
Yes, it can.
You do not want to mess this up.
No.
But this is gorgeous. This takes 45 minutes. That's it. You roast it without the topping, and then you put a little of that garlic paste and breadcrumbs on top. It's worthy, and you won't mess it up.
Oh, it's so good.
Mm-hmm.
And there are all kinds of goodies in this book. Mm-hmm. Best of all, there is a color photo with every single recipe.
Oh, yeah.
You will also find progressive photos, meaning step-by-step photos on some of the recipes. You will also see a listing in the back of the chefs from Cook's Country's favorite brands
Absolutely.
Of different ingredients.
Yes.
Now, I'm not going to tell you what they are. You have to buy the book to find out. But when the experts say that X brand of rice or ketchup or whatever is the best, that's the one I'm going to go for, right?
That's it. Yeah, because we taste them blind. We taste them straight. We taste them in recipes to determine which supermarket products work in recipes.
Is it time for ranch buttermilk fried chicken?
So good.
So right
so these
there
are
on the
thighs.
End.
They're boneless thighs. And, you know, a lot of recipes, you didn't get that ranch flavor. We fixed that but we by coating it with buttermilk that we put the three fresh herbs in, chives, cilantro, and scallions.
Mm.
And then we put that in the breadcrumb. And then we deep fried them.
Oh.
And then a little bit of that herb mixture gets into the sauce with a little mayonnaise. This is some of my favorite fried chicken, part because it's thighs and they're juicy and they're boneless. You can kind of just put it on a piece of bread and go to town. Isn't that good?
And you get all that flavor right through the crust.
Yes.
There's nothing more frustrating than when the crust is bland and then you get to the meat and the meat has no choice but to be bland because there's nothing that's going to deliver the flavor.
That's it.
1,500 bucks are gone.
All right, before we
now,
get to dessert.
Now, the last time you were here, you gave me some of this.
Yes.
And I couldn't stop eating it.
Yes.
This chili is amazing. Tell us about it.
Yes, this is Colorado green chili, and it's pork, not beef.
Right.
And it uses Anaheim chilies, which are very mild. They're a little bit sweeter and more mild than a green pepper, and just a couple jalapenos. So it's not very spicy, but it just has a really rich, deep flavor.
And you know what? It feels like autumn. It feels like comfort food, right?
It's a really nice way to have chili that's not spicy, that's a little something different.
I'm a man of a certain age. Can't eat the spice so much anymore.
I hear you.
And I appreciate this so much. And the pork is so melt in your mouth.
Oh, you have to use pork shoulder, which luckily is very inexpensive. Mm. But it's what makes the stew so tender.
Okay, I'm going to go out on a limb here, and I've had my fair share of comparison. That's the best chili I've ever had.
Wow.
Ever.
I kind of agree with you.
You guys, I'm not playing.
Yeah.
This chili is... Mr. Rosselli, you need to try this chili one day, sir. Because I know you all got some good pork products over there at Rosselli.
Know what? I haven't made this in a while. That broth is good.
Mm.
It just has that backbone.
Here is, here's a spoon so you can have a little
taste. I did it.
Oh, you already snapped
one? I already did. This is the Guinness beef stew.
Let me show inside the book real quickly. 2,000 books are gone. Look at these gorgeous color photos. Look at the tips, the tricks, the hints, the things you need to know about the recipes. You're going to love Alabama barbecued chicken. You're going to love pasta with a mushroom sauce.
Oh, you cook that right in the sauce with the mushrooms.
Arroz con pollo, that's chicken with rice.
Yes.
Really lovely. Sweet corn spoon bread. I love spoon
it's
bread.
It's the fresh corn in there that makes all the difference.
Oh, my goodness. And then you got crown roasted pork. I'll tell you, I have every Cook's Country and America's Test Kitchen cookbook in my kitchen. You're my go-to reference in my kitchen.
Thank you.
And I have to say, there in my mind, there's no higher authority.
This is one of the recipes I make once a week. It's chicken cut up on potatoes, and it's a one-pan dinner, which makes it really easy to get dinner on the table.
2,200 books are gone, and I'm just going to take a sneak peek in the back of the book where all of the ingredient recommendations are, and I'm just going to tell you, oh, those are the hot dogs you like.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, those are the ones.
And this is the hot sauce you recommend?
It's so good.
And that's the brand of, oh, of grapefruit juice you like?
Isn't that surprising?
And if I'm going to put ice cream in a recipe, you like that
that's
brand.
That's the one. That's the one.
Oh.
That ice cream. It's surprising ice cream brand.
You better buy the book because they're all in the back there. This becomes your recipe and your reference guide.
Yes.
Do you love slow cookers? We all do.
Yeah.
But here's the problem. If I do a baked pasta in a slow cooker, I worry that it's going to burn on the bottom.
It does, doesn't it?
How do I stop that?
Yeah, you see this handy little foil collar. You just put a foil collar in there before you fill it with food, and it prevents it from burning on the side. Mm. The other trick to pasta in there is you toast it in the microwave with a little oil before you cook it. So it's raw pasta out of the box in a bowl, little oil in the microwave, you toast it, that toasts the wheat so it doesn't get mushy. Don't you hate it when those mushy bakes Edie? A little bit of ricotta.
Hold that, please.
Ricotta.
Happy dance, happy dance. Get it. 3,000 books are gone. This gooey, melty cheese bread is going to be.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to have a love affair with this. Let me turn around this way.
Look at that.
Look at this.
Oh, this is a favorite of Wisconsin. It's a spicy cheese bread.
It's I'm not kidding.
Really easy to make. So that's like a roll for you, isn't it?
Right.
So it's provolone and Monterey Jack. It gets melted and wrapped in there. It's a classic in Wisconsin. And so we got the recipe. We made it work. Mm. All right.
They're telling me I'm all out of time and I'm sick about it because I want to stay here and eat with
you. One more thing.
What do you got?
This is the chocolate eclair cake. Oh, this is a make-ahead refrigerator dessert. So it's graham crackers, but you make like a filling and you put the chocolate on top. Isn't that good?
Buy this book. Buy this book. And after that, buy this book. 4,000 books are gone.
Wow.